Dear participants, welcome to the online class on the menu design. This topic is related to the advanced food and beverage operation 1 of the 5th semester of the BSc HHA. My name is Amit Gupta. I am assistant professor with the Chitkara School of Hospitality. Menu design plays a very important role in the revenue and marketing of a given restaurant. This is what I am going to prove through the different slides that I am going to share with you all. The first thing we need to understand that what we are going to cover in this topic would be, I am going to talk about the introduction to the menu. I am going to talk about the menu design factor. I will talk about different types of menu cards, and at the last I will talk about menu configuration with few of the pictures related to the menu design. So let's move forward and let's start with the introduction. We all know that menu is an important tool for marketing by a given restaurant, because without a menu card or without a menu either displayed or on a card, it is very difficult to market your product efficiently. So we need to have a menu card or a menu display on a given wall, which could be in any forms, which replicates the kind of standard the restaurant is. So menu card signifies the standard of the restaurant. What quality of menu card that we have, based on that the standard is being created of a particular restaurant. Now what does the menu have? Menu have many things. Menu project the dishes and beverages for a particular restaurant. The food could be in different courses, and the beverage could be alcoholic, non-alcoholic, mocktails, wine list, and so on. So let's move forward with the menu design factor. The few of the points that we need to keep in mind when we prepare the menu card are that menu card must be legible and easy to read. It means the menu card should be easy to, it should not be very complicated. A simple language should be used. Menu covers a symbol of the restaurant's identity. We all know that menu signifies the standard of a given restaurant. So it is a symbol to the restaurant. Now difference, the type, style, size, colors, and background of the menu card should be appropriate. Types of material on which menu is printed should be in keeping with restaurant image, color, decor. Okay. Now it says generally 10 to 12 of menu listing size of 18 for heading should be there. Now varying type size menu design type sizes are there in the menu card to prevent monotony, otherwise become monotony in nature. Menu heading should be in capital nature and should be bold in nature. Lowercase easier to read word as or the a in and with are usually not capitalized. Additional emphasis by drawing box or border around menu item should be there, which I am going to show in the coming slides. Menu items are often put in large bold caps to stand out, and lowercase types used to describe material used for preparing the dish. This is what are the few of the menu design factors that should be there. Now when we talk about different types of menu configurations, menu could be, we have divided into three columns, that is menu configurations, area of most attention and area of least attention, and there are four rows. So we have menu card which could be in one panel, it could be in two panel, it could be three book panel style, and there could be many panels. These are four different configurations of the menu card. Okay, so one panel talks about top of the page has the most attention. Now it says area of least attention in this kind of one panel menu card is that just below the bottom of the page. If you one panel menu covers display menu items on both sides of the cover, all entrees should appear on the front side, as those on the back will not receive as much attention, because we would like to see the front page of the menu card. So at the back we generally don't give too relevancy. Two panel. Now area of attention is top of the right side panel. Now the area of least attention in this kind of menu card just above the bottom of the left side panel of the menu card have a least attention. Three panel book style is the third different type, is the third variety of the menu design. Now the area of most attention is top of the third panel. Old textbook says that the inside of the middle panel constitutes the best location, but I have found that the top of the third panel gets more respect in that it is seen as having the best menu items. Now just above the bottom of the panel has got the first panel has got the least attention. Many panels have top of each page is the most attention. Just above the bottom of the each page does not have too much attention. So these are the different types of menu configurations cards that is available worldwide in the restaurant business. Now look at the picture. If you look at the picture, it's a two panel menu card, if I'm not wrong. Now if you look at the front page of the menu card, the color pattern they have used is very intrinsic in nature and it is very attractive in nature, which signifies the standard of a particular restaurant. Look at the menu card. It's a single panel menu card where the menu is being divided into different sections. Like on the upper case, on the top is the name of the restaurant. On the left hand side are the starters, the other herbs, which is being segregated from the right hand side by an arrow, which has got some exclusive food dishes that is being served by the restaurants. If you look at the left hand side extreme below, you will find there is one block that is being created which says plat du jour. It means this of the day. So it means the restaurant has some specialty menu for that particular day also. And in the middle, towards the right hand side, you will find that the entrees are there, which talks about the main courses that is available for dining. And at the below, you will find the plat pour deux, that is the few of the dishes of that day. Okay, so and in every aspect, you will find on the right hand side of the menu, you will find that price list is being written. And below that, there are certain things which is written in the box, which signifies it is being written in the bold, so that whenever you are reading the looking at the menu, your concentration goes on those bold letters, which is in different colors, right from black to red in color. So this is one second form of menu card design. If you look at this picture, you will find it is again a single panel and it has got different blocks and menus are being written with lots of emphasis given on the font size and with little description about the food items, with different blocks being used to get attention of the guest. Now look at the another menu card. It is a three-fold menu, so three panel menu card that is there, and they have used two colors in the menu card to have the attention of the guest, and the headings are being written in bold letters with the background of black, with all food item that is there in the menu card. It is bold in nature, but the font size is lesser than the heading, and every food item that is there, they are being elaborated so that the guest can order it in the right fashion, and price is also being written. This is what I have planned for today. I hope the session was very interesting to you all. By going through this slide, all slide, you would be able to prepare your menu card. Thank you for participating in the class. Have a great day ahead. Bye bye.